flat tire in the middle of a long journey? Well, we all have to be prepared for that. And you might not have always someone to help you out. Hello and welcome to an episode of DIY videos powered by Hyundai. Today we show you easy steps on how to change a flat tire. Let's take a look at how you can change a flat tire by yourself. As soon as you realize you have a flat tire, find the nearest safe place to park. While doing so, make sure you do not abruptly brake or turn. Slow down and pull over to the side. An empty parking lot would be ideal. Find a level stretch of a road so that your car doesn't roll. Do not change the tire on a narrow road or near oncoming traffic. Turn on the hazard light so that you're visible to other drivers and avoid a collision. Once you have stopped, use a parking brake. Also put it on first or reverse gear before replacing the flat tire so that the car doesn't roll. Using wheel wedges is also recommended for this purpose. It is advisable to place the hazard triangle near the vehicle, which will give you a working space. If you have a tire with the hubcap, remove the hubcap before setting up the jack. You can use the flat end of your lug wrench or other suitable tool to remove the hubcap. But right now, we have a variant which has alloys, so you will directly move on to the next step. It's time to loosen the lug nuts. Turn them counterclockwise. You might have to use a bit of force to do this. If needed, you could also use your body weight. One by one, loosen the lug nuts. Loosen the lug nuts in a star formation, but don't remove them completely yet. You can use that once you're ready to remove the wheel from the vehicle. Now it's time to place the jack under the vehicle. Firstly, find the vehicle from alongside the flat tire. You'll probably see an area of exposed metal for the jack to safely lift and place the jack without any damage to the vehicle. Take a look at the instructions in the vehicle owner's manual. Start by placing wedges next to the tire so that it stays in place. This is especially important on asphalt roads. Once you have the jack in place, raise the vehicle until the flat tire is some inches above the ground. Be careful, don't put any body part under the vehicle until you have completely raised it. After raising the vehicle, it's time to remove the lug nuts. As you've already loosened them, you can just remove them by hand. Then grab the tire by the treads and slowly pull it towards you. Place it on its side so that it doesn't roll away. Now you can put on the spare tire. Place it on the hub and line up the rim with the lug bolts. Push gently until the lug bolts show through the rim. You can then start securing the spare tire in place by tightening the lug nuts. Tighten them as much as possible with your hands. After this, use a jack to lower the vehicle until the spare tire resets on the ground. Don't lower it all the way yet. With the jack still, tighten the nuts using the wrench by turning the nuts clockwise. Tighten the nuts using your body weight. Always remember, the lug nuts have to be tightened one by one in star formation, cross condition. Then it's time to lower the vehicle and remove the jack. Slowly bring the vehicle all the way to the ground and double check the lug nuts. If you had a hubcap covering the nuts, put it back on. If it does not fit the spare tire, put it back with the equipment. Gather all pieces of equipment and put them in your vehicle. Before you are on your way again, there is one more thing you need to do. Check the air pressure on the spare tire to be sure that it is good to be used on the road. The temporary spare tires come in handy. They can't be used to drive long distances or at a high speed. So visit a tire technician to get your tire repaired or replaced. Hope you all found this video useful. Now the next time you are stuck with a flat tire, you know what to do.